Hello everyone and welcome to Cooper Studios. Today is Tutorial Tuesday and we're making the Warthog. I did a previous tutorial on how to make this model that I used from Battle of the Brick a long time ago, but it wasn't very good and a lot of you have been telling me you wanted a new one. So here it is. This is the new one. This new tutorial. Here we go.
So this is the original Warthog model that I made for Battle of the Brick and that I used to animate in Battle of the Brick. And I've kept it together ever since. But today we're going to take it apart. So most of this is really just a simple Technic chassis that allows the front to angle down and the back to angle downward. Then you have two independent steering mechanisms, one at the front and one at the back. And that's why this model is a little larger scale. It's not quite to the average minifigure scale. He's much smaller. I mean, look how large the tire is, you know. That's the only problem with the model. It's a little too big. However, I think it's a really good design, especially if you want to get this kind of action going on in here. So I'm going to take it apart and we're going to see if I can put it back together again. Okay, so these are the main parts taken off the Warthog. You have the chassis, which you'll have to take apart even more so. We have the front bumper, which is holds everything up here, the tow hook being the most important thing. But this is a little bit to the right. See how it's a little bit uneven there? Don't ask me why, I don't know. The answer is pi. I have no idea why it does that. We have the windshield, which is on a slight tilt. We have the two sides to the Warthog. They are pretty unique. We have the back majority of the Warthog piece, and we have the chain gun that goes on the back that rotates. So we're going to take these apart in steps and put it all together. By the way, the links to the close-up high-res pictures of all these models are in the description. Should go to Flickr or something, so check that out. But here is the chassis piece. This is the main chassis piece. It's really just, again, two Technic angles going this way and that way, and then a frame holding it up from the side. And everything is all about making these two things move. So I'm going to take it apart, and we're going to get to it. All right, so first let's start off with the wheels. You have to make four of these, obviously, and they're big, massive wheels. And what they are is this. You take a 2x2 gray cylinder and a kind of one of these bubble-shaped hubcap pieces, and you attach it to the end. Then you stick it inside one of these kind of tires. It says 04-5 tire. You push it down inside that tire, and then you have to put this tire inside the larger tire. This tire is a 30.4x14. It's what it says on the rubber. So you just have to really work and stretch the tire and fit it around the smaller one to give you this big, massive, industrial-looking tire. And then you just attach one of these Technic rods into each one. And so put the tires over on the side, and now we're going to make the main part of the chassis. All right, so here's how you put together the basic part of the chassis. You want to take a light gray 1x4 Technic brick with the holes in the center and attach two Technic pins onto the inside. Then take one of these. This is a 1x8 Technic brick with holes and attach it right into the center. Now for the end piece, take a two more black Technic pins, attach them on the ends there, and then attach a 1x6, two of these, two 1x6 Technic bricks to each side. And that way, both sides are going to make this kind of angle when they're put together. So that's that. And then we do the other side exactly the same. Two Technic pins in here, 1x8. Attach it in the center, like that. And now more Technic pins on the side. And then the Technic brick, the 1x6. One there and one there. Now when you put them together, flip it upside down. And just to keep it together temporarily, right here, we'll put a 1x2. This is very temporary. Okay, then we turn it this way, and to prepare it, this is the angle we're going for, although right now it doesn't really matter. So that's the angle. Now we've got to attach both the front and rear. Actually, I'm not sure which is which. This is the rear driving mechanism, and this is the front driving mechanism. So we have to attach them to this chassis. Okay, we're going to make the forward chassis first for the front wheels. We have to first take one of these unique Technic pins with the four studs on top, turn upside down. Then we want to take one of these pieces. I don't know what it's called. It's very odd, but it's a Technic Lego piece. We're going to attach the pin side to this side right here, and we're going to attach one of the smallest Technic pins through there. So it'll attach that under there, just like that, so it'll swivel, and then take one of these end clipper pieces and attach to the bottom like that, so it swivels. And we do the same thing to this side, attach it here, one of the Technic pins right through there, and then a Technic end piece, like a washer, right at the end there. And then you have to get two of these swivel pieces, these Lego pieces, and you fit this part into this part, like that. Fit this part into this part, like this. Now what you do is you want these faced like this, and now we're going to attach it to the front of the chassis. So really what you do is you let it hang and you put it from underneath, right, like that. And then you just attach it to the very front. Just clip these. One there. And one there, like that. And now you have the edges. And what we're going to do is we're going to put the tires in each one of these sides so that we have the articulation, the wheel articulation. So that's the front side. Now we got to create the back side, which is a little bit more difficult. For the back side, take one of these pieces, this Technic piece, turn it upside down. Take one of these weird pieces, I do not know what it's called, and you have to turn this so that the bottom part, see this? It's lower on one side, keep the lower side downwards. You do the same thing to this side. Okay, like that. Now, attach another one on top. And that holds these together in the center. Okay? Now, we're going to have to put wheels on here. So it's easier to do this side. Take one of these Technic pins. Slide it through. Take a Technic washer. Put it on one side. See what we're doing here? Take another Technic washer. Put it on the other side. Just like that. And you can push in the end a little more so that it's snug. Now we do the same thing on the other side. Technic piece. Technic washer. On the inside. And now a Technic washer on the outside. There we go. Alright, we're almost set and the wheels are going to go on the side. So now for the back, take another one of these, put it upside down, but put it on the bottom. So what we're trying to do is get these two top black pieces here to line up. So put it on the bottom, and then what we want to do is attach it with a Technic pin, the very small Technic pins, the smallest ones, and then attach it inside like that, and now attach washers to the end pieces. One there, one there, one here. and one there. Ta-da! And now it rotates on axis. What we want to do is for the back of the chassis, we have to slide this through the middle so that it gets up to the middle. So pop the top part off real gently and lay it right in the center, just like that. And now keeping this across just like this, push down and it should fit. There it is. And it should fit. Oh no, I have it wrong. You're supposed to put it one more back so that this bar is attached there. Ta-da! Like that. So that the back end slides. See what it's doing? And this is going to be the rear. Now, attach it like this, and we have to put on the top part. And these pieces that make the inside of the body also help keep the structure at a downward slope like this. All right, now before we put on the rest of this, we want to add the other two wheel holders Technic pins. So you want to take same size Technic pin. And what we want to do is turn this like that, like so. We want to slide this in the hole. And then we need to, the most difficult part is to put a Technic little washer on the inside here so that it can't come out. So the best way to do this is to tilt it on side. Uh-oh, my alarm. It's telling me I have something to do. Okay. So place the Technic washer on the inside right there, and then you can just press down with the Technic pin. Like that, see? So that's what we want. And then we just do the same thing to the other side. Technic washer, there we go. And now that side's in. So now we have a place to put the wheels when we're ready. Okay, but first, take one of these, a 4x4 light gray square, and put it smack dab in the middle, just like this. Remember, tilt these two sides down a little bit. Now, I'm basically just taking this thing apart as I go. So we want to take two 1x4s, attach them to the very front, like this, and the very back of the side Technic bars. What that's not going to allow it to do is going to keep these on a slight angle. And that's the real trick. That's the magic right there. That's going to keep it. Now everything else is just built on top of this basic frame. Okay, take one of these. A 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10. A 2x10. 2x10 and place it directly on the front, just like this, so that the front is lined up with this, and push down. All right, it's going to keep it together. Take two 2x2 plates, attach them together, place it on the front. There we go. Now a slope, preferably with a print on it, right here on the front. And then some sort of 1x2 tile to give it some detail. Now for the center, here we go. Take something that looks like the centerpiece for your console and put it right there in the middle. Then on the side right here, we want to take a 1x1 tile, place it right here, right there. Then take a 1x1 Technic brick with a hole in it, place it there on the side so you can see the hole. And we do the same thing to the other side. Okay. Right there. Now across the top, first take a little steering wheel. This is one of these 1x1 plates with a headlamp piece. and then one of these larger steering wheels. I like this steering wheel. It looks better than the smaller ones. And place it on the far left side. See? For the steering wheel piece. And then take some sort of one-by-one tile to keep them together and place it on the right side. Now, we can take the tack. This is sort of like a detail brick, a 1x2, and attach it right there so that people can sit here. Then we want to do the rest. Let's see. What is the rest? So here's the rest. Take two of these 1x1 squares and attach them right here. One there, and one there on the back. Now I want to take we want to make this shape just it's a 4x4 square with a 2x2 plate on top and two flat 1x1 tiles there. Attach this on the back portion just like that and press down. And that's where we're going to put the turret. See? We're going to put the turret right here on the side. So this makes the basic frame, and now we can continue to more of the side pieces. So here's what we do with the side pieces. Take a 1x3, put it right there. Take one of these, it's a gray, all gray sloping piece, and a 1x1 tile. Place the 1x1 tile on the left side. And there you go, on this side. Now we're going to attach the other side too. Same thing, 1x3, right there. One of these, and one of these on the side. Ta-da! Now, what you can also do is you can place a 1x1 piece and center like that. We can do it again over here just to make it even for everybody. In fact, that's probably what I should do. I'm trying to play it off as like I didn't screw up, but I kind of screwed up. So you should put a 1x1 piece in there. This is why I wanted to skip this part. It's difficult. Okay. Correct. Okay, now we put the slope on this side, and same thing on this side, I believe. I hope so. I'm pretty sure this is the way it's put together. If we come to a problem later, we'll address that. But there it goes. It's going to bend backwards a little bit like this. And this is the main frame. This is the main frame of the body. And now we can continue with more detail pieces, like the back part, which is really, really simple. For the back bumper piece, go to the end here. For the two end pieces, take two of these. One there. This is a tile with one stud in the center. Another one there. Okay. Now take a downward, hinge piece. Place it right on top of these. Right there, okay. Bend it down slightly. Take two of these little contraptions. One, two little clips. And now to make the back bumper of the Warthog, just take a bunch of these single studs. I think there are five in each. Make a row of five, attach one on that side, and then make a row of five. Attach on the other side. And if you want to create brake lights, what you can do here is you can just go one, two gray ones, and then attach two translucent red elements in there somewhere, and then two more regular studs, and you create brake lights or reverse lights, whatever you want. But this is the main back, and that's pretty good. And now we're going to continue with the model. I hope none of these extra pieces are important.
Yeah.
Cooper Studios.